So, okay, finally we get the picture. Just saw a black screen for a short while. We are back with HoI3 and HPP, our Soviet Union campaign. We are in Central Europe. We have defeated Germany, of course, and we now have a puppet in the German Democratic Republic. And towards the end of the last stream, we have opened hostilities with the Allies. It's late in 1942, November, to be precise. And we've had some initial success. Of course, we are attacking across a wide front, reaching from basically... I believe this is the Vesuve volcano near Naples in southern Italy. The front reaches to French-occupied Germany. In western Germany, where the borders of Germany, Belgium, and the Netherlands. We are having some issues here, namely with breaking through the Maginot Line. Apparently. There is only one level of fortification here, but we're trying to break through to a lot more. They fully built up their fortifications. We're struggling there. The first Soviet shock army and the first cavalry army are tasked with this breakthrough. But it's not going anywhere, so we have to think about turning. The Red Army is securing Denmark. Our northern flank, a small contingent of the 8th Army. That shouldn't take too much longer. And we have some coastal, some forces securing the coast. 7th Army is here. And actually Northern Italy is quite a successful theater also so far. Namely, we have broken out of the eastern part of the North Italian plains, and we have pushed right across the boots, so to say. We have secured Genova. We have a couple of fast armor divisions exploiting this breakthrough. Also encircled Milano. Hopefully we'll capture a French infantry division. We are also securing a pocket, large pocket, basically the western part of central Italy. Hopefully also destroying or capturing as many divisions as possible so that France can't move them to the mainland. Have them cause more problems for us. Southern Italy only seems very weakly defended at this point. There is division of light armor and some cavalry. Otherwise, I'm not aware of any major forces. But we are not moving here because the priority is securing central Italy and securing also, importantly, a avenue of approach into southern France across the Oceanic Alps, I believe. That's what they should be called in English. Mediterranean Alps, basically the stretch between the Swiss border and the Mediterranean coast around Nice. Speaking of which, we could also switch over to brain map mode to give us a bit more information. We are stretched thin a little bit here, because I am actually moving ahead for my armor. I'm pushing as far as I can, but I would like to close any gaps. So I'm moving infantry over. Not quite. I don't have excessive armor left in Italy. I only basically have one core. Speaking of which, I should probably move up the headquarters. The problem is, armor would be useful to quickly secure these ports and prevent France from evacuating any units here. However, tanks are currently engaged between Genova and Milan. Infantry hasn't had time yet to move up. And they're also tasked with the very important mission here to secure the road into southern France. Okay, so that's basically it for the southern theater. And then for the northern or central European theater, we're not making great headways. Well, we have driven the French off their initial line of defense. They've fallen back onto the Maginot line, and it's not looking very good for these battles here. Although, yeah, the line of defense is very thin. There aren't a lot of troops back, which, you know, the battles could still look quite tough, but they might actually pull back any moment. If I'm looking at the respective, so over here, this division is losing strength. They're only down to 5%. They don't have any reserves really, and they're also a bit fast. But the attacking divisions are looking much better. But we are facing a hefty force modifier, minus 98.8%. Look at this province here. The two divisions defending here getting disorganized. One is almost disorganized. They also have lost considerable strength, while here only one of my divisions is losing strength, or isn't maybe also completely mobilized yet. And then here, battle isn't going well. Some of my divisions aren't yet mobilized. And we are facing a hefty group modifier. Full strength, fully organized marine infantry divisions. And so, not going terribly well, but we're going to destroy a couple of French divisions. The air battle, I'll look at later. So what are the scenarios? What are the possible alternatives here? Because I've actually thought about this problem. I mean, obviously it would be nice to just get one more province, because then we would basically break through into the east plains of eastern France, where I think I have about 30 armored divisions in this theater. I have 30 armored divisions ready to break through and to run them off in France. Unless, until we can do that, they aren't much use. And well, as we see, they aren't very good at breaking through the Maginot line. The other idea would be, so what are the alternatives? Even when I started planning the operation against France, I already considered this problem. We have two alternatives. We have an alternative war between violating the Dutch and Belgian neutrality. Both of these are not yet in the Allies. So they are basically secure for us. The advantage would be we would in time also be securing our northern flank, but we'd have to shift quite a number of divisions north. Another alternative would be to violate Switzerland's neutrality by basically pushing through weak French defenses west of Munich, and then basically parallel to the Alps across the Swiss plains to France. And the third alternative that basically appeared as a result of the Danes so far would be to switch from attacking the Maginot Line directly to basically push back across the Rhine, cut off a whole number of French divisions in southern Germany, and try to outflank basically French defenses in the north. And this is currently the most promising alternative. First of all, I am already pushing across here. We've won the battle here. We're pushing away basically a motorized and regular infantry division headquarters. And we could push along the Rhine north, south, and then back across into French territory. And the advantage here obviously would be I wouldn't have to move a lot of armored divisions either to the north or to the south. And I already basically secured the break. I think this is basically what I want to do. I am also moving in mountain infantry and additional infantry with armored support, engineer support, which should help in attacking them fortified positions. I think the idea should be to pull back armored divisions and try to outflank the enemy this way. Let's switch off the battle plan and let's try to do that. Let's try to exploit this breakthrough. So for this purpose we are going to put away some armored units. Here I saw two weakened infantry divisions. They are disorganized and have lost strength. They aren't fully mobilized yet, so give them no order to hold. thing for this armor division. Right on here. Here. Through this pocket. Started again. Our waste dies. Our waste dies. Okay, that's AI. Okay, switched over. Yet. That's the production needs shift. Make sure. Yes, we are securing Rome, cutting off new infantry division, light armor, and motorized infantry in the south. Then we should try. This is a breakthrough core that I'm using here. Using somewhat stronger commanders. 5, 4. And let's try to secure ports, many ports as possible. We see a counterattack. Capital, and let's move some more. Pull the armor back out. Well, actually, let's keep it ready in the north. We don't know when, for instance, Dutch decide to switch sides. Bring most of our divisions. So. Yeah. Okay, so here there isn't really anything. Not really making any progress here. Thinking about see if we can get anything from Beacon. Let's see if this province is the most promising at the moment. We went up to 15%. here. A bunch. We should immediately put use for outflanking. We are being attacked in Munich. Of course, Munich. Things looking here. I think we can secure Roma. Question is what we're going to do. We'll have to do. Breakthrough for and we were controlling the Baltic Strait. Yes, we puppeted Denmark. Like the British are pulling back their infantry. I'm not sure. Maybe I should use my. Yeah, I should use my armor units in the south to exploit basically the open gap here. Maybe that's more important than securing central Italy. Because they can't really go anywhere fast. See if we can secure Marseille. See if we can exploit this. There is a whole bunch of armored and motorized units here, which I would like to keep some in the north, so I'm not sure whether the Dutch will suddenly switch sides. I might even, or whether we indeed will need to break through in the north. I'm actually going to this for here. There's the first armored core. It will stay there for the moment. I retain some flexibility. I don't think it's worth to send the whole course out. Move one infantry division over. We don't have very many reserves in the south. Back here. Have a little problem here. We're also losing some convoys. There is some resistance here. Marine infantry. We're improving our electronic computing, improving our research efficiency. Cavalry corps. Capture these Norwegians here, Norwegian infantry, south of the Swiss border. Moving up with some armor. Rome is protected, or cut off. Unfortunately, we didn't get flooded. Are pulling back. Follow. That's attack. And we are sinking some British transports. It looks like we are able to outflank the French, though we are definitely stretching our troops. Attack. We have crossed the river here, now we need to destroy it. We can have some cars. This way. Then three divisions back this way. Maybe we can cut off some more divisions here. I'll pull away some armor. If we can break through here. Yeah, looks like we're cutting off a number of French divisions. If it works, it will be excellent. Here. French are hunting ourselves. Not bad. One flotilla gone. Just paid attention to that. See if I can evacuate them to the port so I can at least save the second floor. There is some good news. Some good news. We need to keep attack. Thank you. were we fighting here? So that's about 5-6 divisions. We have encircled in Moscow. French occupied Germany. Here. Worth this attack. Same time, keep the pressure up. On the Maginot line, here is some more armor that I'm going to pull out. We'll move up to the Maginot line so I can pull away this armor as well. I'm moving some armor headquarters now. Recruits, nice, from Denmark, Hungary. Romania and Bulgaria. That's great. Take a look. Hopefully. Okay, some armor in southern Italy. Nothing too serious. Here we are having other headquarters. They're looking good here. Norwegians are dealt with for the most part. I want to move up my infantry. Potentially use them in France. Stop this attack here. Munich is secured. Breakthrough on the eastern shores of Rhine has worked. We're pushing into southern Germany. Hopefully we can exploit the gap here, maybe push across to Offenburg against Strasbourg. Maybe this way into central France. That would be a nice success. Regime in Croatia is weak, gains more manpower. My division health. Order. Croatia. Here is ours, Battle of Auckland. Nice. Croatia is blue. But Hungary is intervening on our behalf. We have an intervention in Trieste. I'm going to have to take a quick break to get some water, and I'll be right back. Okay, let's continue. First of all, I haven't checked the research at all. Oh, I'm about to lose. Back here to prevent them from taking Genova. Back to this headquarters. Division is a bit of a pickle, but it's okay. We have taken the last meaningful port for France in the Mediterranean. I don't know, I think we should cut off these divisions. I'll use one motorized division back to militia. I'll push north with two more divisions. Back here. first infantry. The Swiss are getting nervous as well. But the south overall, I would say, looks good. And in the north, we have broken through here. I think we're opening central France is open for us. Looking pretty promising. Push ahead with these divisions. Maybe we should cut off. I think we will push across the Rhine and then cut off French forces in southern Germany. I think that's a reasonable plan. I haven't checked the Air Force. I could cancel some orders. But then we'll just see back. Go in. Let's get some new orders. Tactical bombers. So put them on the picture. Very defensive. So French will move out the unit out of the pocket in southeastern Germany. Fighters are taking some damage with the disorganization. Holding up or that's heavy fighters. This is the air map. There are some bombings. British. Put them on an air intercept mission. For our own territory. Have some Soviet bombers here. I don't think there is any, there isn't much air defense in the south. A little bit progressive. Light fighters. I think we've broken through the French line. Also, the defense of the Maginot is weakened. I think they're pulling away the troops, and that's what we're seeing here. They're moving already. try to exploit that. Loading up as many tanks as I can. Wait, it's mobilizing. Put the moves out, try to secure Titan Circle. So this is not working. We'll move this way. We can't fight in the fortifications without tanks working, so we'll try to cut them off here. And of course, we still have to move in some. Circle the Maginot Line. Artillery advance. Seems sure. We push through as many units. More tank divisions west. There is an additional number of divisions. me here. Basically only head for it. See if we can encircle a French motorized division. Genoa is secured. Rome is secured. This means we can attack across the wide front. The 11th Corps will secure southern Italy, so we decide to push there as well, reduce the pockets in the north. This infantry division. And of course, the central Italian pocket. Resistance in Croatia is being dealt. There's also a small road into Persia. See if we can make some headway here. And I'm also interested to see what's going on far east. Do you have any nasty surprises? Japan is making some light headway. See if we can secure Lyon. The southern flank is pretty much open to us. Having some issues here. Cycle in some more motivations. ever say overall. Further secure. Move in some more division here. Reinforce the attack. Here we should move in. That was all almost over with the French infantry. So there will be quite a number of divisions captured in the south. The 71st Infantry Division is reorganized. They were defending Genova. And we'll see if we can use it to secure Livorno. Maybe we'll also use the Infantry Division as soon as they have taken care of these two. In the north. Nothing here. There's a 10th division in. There are some headquarters. The infantry division, I think. And the 10th division. I'm just trying to block them off. Too fast. Maybe I should attack on this. Order to slow down. Right, moving their units. lot of militia. Which militia fight? Maybe we should. Some attack backwards. If we can cut off all these units here, and British are going, they tend to retake the and to retake our state. Obviously, we would let them pull away one armor division. And that's not happening. Of the fortification units here, if that works. And then there is a whole bunch of armor. So this infantry division is getting disorganized, the rest is headquarters. Let's drive away this militia. Italy. Oh, something went wrong here. See if we can throw this medium armor division out. City. Are quite strong, 5-3. Ours are 5. Okay. Have a slight damage. We have some research problems. Take a quick look. Researching something ahead of time. Small arms. Interception tactics. Let's research some. Let's improve our fighters. AI is complaining about fuel. Burning through a lot of escorts. It is what it is. How are things looking here? We need to push ahead. Medium armor building up. Here we need. Push ahead. See if we can cut off the German units in Germany. Our division will attack the British division just north of Marseille. And we have some more strategic bombers to deploy. In BTIP. Let's take a look at production point. We are building a nuclear research lab. The idea is to build nuclear bombs. We are also building convoys. We are building a light carrier. Some upgrades to motorized infantry. Some other units to fill up some half-empty divisions, some more heavy bombers, marine infantry, airborne infantry. How is Persia looking? Okay, across the river. progress in Persia. Although this is going to be a whole other problem. We have some spare infantry, we'll try to... unit. We have a whole bunch of people. That's terrible, but also not. But we are circling quite a number of divisions. Not ideally using about divisions are all concentrated. We have opened a gap here. Maybe we can finally start making some division. To keep the armor. The 7th Cavalry Corps headquarters needs to move up. French are landing in Vienna. These two divisions will turn around. Three infantry divisions. I should have left one division in the port. that would have prevented them from attacking there. Might land before we get there. Shouldn't be too much of a problem. It's a Norwegian there. Looking at the port. Wait for it. I'll be more careful with my ports. I'll leave an infantry division behind. Having these landings in the back. Improving the jet engine. Infantry division amount with light armor. being convoy attacked here in the Black Sea, actually. Did we have? We have two air fleets of naval guard. I thought we had more than that. Some more subs here that we should have done. Wait up. Captain, I'm very hungry. Convoy warfare right now. Liberate Gente shortly. And all these units here have basically only one port left. We should run into supply problems soon. Bring up some infantry divisions. And we might soon link up west of Switzerland. Going to need some more divisions here. Thank you. But we are being attacked in the... Really shouldn't be great. Pushing into the south. Send some divisions north to reinforce. I'm going to have to think about automating these headquarters here. I can take care of more pressing. I think now we have some decent bases for further operation. Up with these infantry divisions. There's some issues here. Storming our beach, but this is in the very north. I'll see if we can get Finland to help out. Don't really have any fighting units. That's pretty much it. Let's see. French are putting up, or the Norwegians and British are putting up a fight. Hopefully. Take one more province over here. Only keep pushing the French forces in southern Italy south. Also cleaning up these pockets here, increasing divisions link up with our forces north of Switzerland. Here and lost up to Villa. Research is possible. A lot of motorized things to get up to date with our mechanized and motorized units. Base. Okay, and we have the troops occupying the Marshall forts, and maybe yes, we'll soon cut off French forts. Finally. Some more locations. We had a little break. French mountain infantry moving in. Some more armor. Okay, northern Italy is pretty much secured. The southern Italy. Big problems there. In the north, we're still struggling, and we have a huge front. Because we're circling several French controlled zones. But I think overall, things are going pretty well. see if we can dash to Paris to armor divisions. Construction. Or the southern flank. Minor breakthroughs, so overall no big problems. So finally, push north here. Reducing 30 pockets. A lot of transport. See if we can make some headway in southern Italy. Okay. Southern Germany is cut off. I suggest we attack the white one. He needs to move up. Should cross the Rhone. See if we can break up here. In counterattack. Reinforced with an infantry division. River crossing isn't going too well. Cancel it. Freeing southern Italy as well. Moving north. and the fight for battle for Paris started. Let's see if we can control it. We are stretched thin a little bit. I get a lot of units here. Bring some infantry to the city as well. We're losing a battle here. Again, if we cross this river. Difficult. A problem with some. Try to move them up. Guard the port. I'm paying for it. Move some infantry up. leaving some divisions behind. Just to get the ports, to keep the ports. Let's go here. There is. Fresh Australian infantry has arrived. Need to care of Paris. For some money, get an espionage bonus, yes. Let's get it. Having some supply issues. Infantry, regular infantry will redeploy to Paris. We suppose should redeploy to the south. Anything that's where we are leaking. friends. The allies are retreating on a wide front. Unfortunately, they aren't looking like they're surrendering anytime soon. We have Ares circled. They're intensifying their convoy warfare. We have moved to reinforce the attack on Paris. We have more armor divisions. We can use them in the north. The armor west. Some more infantry division. West as well. Or the attack on Paris. Push north. Keep hitting them while they're weak. flight. I don't know if they are trying to evacuate or not. Catch them. We have French infantry division that's running amok. They should be out of supply. Losing convoys. Speaking of which, we should probably keep those boats. Things aren't looking too great here. I'm not. We are looking at a pretty invasion. Power and people units here. Division. I want to use my Norwegians have landed with. Garrison. Finnish have sent some militia. It's very kind of them. It should be renamed. Strategic, so we have these. Combat radios are ahead of time. Ahead of combat radio. Plenty of armor technologies to research. We have a slight problem in the southern Soviet Union. A few infantry divisions here. We let's move. West. Leader here. Infantry division will be attached to the 18th Corps. I think with three more infantry divisions and some first support vehicle. Well, they are bringing a lot of units here. That's infantry support, infantry, 12 infantry brigades, cavalry. They are struggling. Pull back. We gotta pick that off. Garrison Omsk. Hopefully we can figure out Okay. Now, for friends. We have basically have friends. Control Italy for a large part. Dealing with the last dangers. I feel like I need control to the AI now. If I do this. Check it. Going to use main system. But it's not too worried. Should be able to take care of the rest of the catch this army. So I can cover. So I can protect those. So I can catch some infantry divisions. Falls. We've seen. Two more divisions. Here. Seven divisions. Orders. people of production. It'd be smart to add some districts. We have some spare spies we should use. Fighting those right now. Finishing up France. Detach four. Actually not. Yeah, it's doing a fine job. France fell, and they are now up it. I know what that means for their armed force. Australian units are here. they keep all these divisions, they might. Okay, so that frees a lot of units, which we'll be using to put an end to this drama over here. Of course, I think the easiest operational plan is to contain them in the north and counterattack in the west, take out Persia. We also have to think about the Middle East, of course. That's a British stronghold, and that will finally give us access to the Mediterranean. We'll move a lot of units this way. There are some minor problems in southern Italy. I also have to make sure guard ports. We might have to secure Belgium and Netherlands, of course. There are a few things left to do during our north. Then we have to take care of the Navy, the Air Force, research and production, get back some territory, all sorts of things to do. But I think I'm going to stream. That's something that we can deal with tomorrow, and then we'll think about the next steps. So France was, after some initial problems, actually not a very long campaign. I would say I think I started the attack in about October 1942, so roughly half a year. Winter campaign, not too many difficulties. Italy, that is. Right. Alright, I'll end the stream here. Thank everybody who stopped by. I'll see you soon.